Welcome back to Sam's Disney Diary in the WDW Fan Zone. This is episode number 11. Remember, samsdisneydiary.com, and you can find all of my videos at youtube.com/samsdisneydiary. And of course, follow me on Twitter at samsdisneydiary.
Hey, WDW Fan Zone, it's Sam from Sam's Disney Diary. And if you're like me, there's nothing better than walking around Epcot's World Showcase Lagoon and finding something new. Just 3 days ago, Spice Road Table opened here in Morocco. It's a new counter service located around World Showcase right against the lagoon. What this does is gives you great views of the boats going around in the daytime or illuminations at night. There's a bar, there's inside seating, there's outside seating, and in addition to the Spice Road Table, there's also a new dessert cart, there's a souvenir shop, and some other little hidden gems inside this new building that's more than just Spice Road Table. So the next time you're walking around World Showcase Lagoon, be sure to swing by, grab a sampler. It's a nice spot to just enjoy the day at Epcot, as always. Thanks again for watching Sam's Disney Diary and Sam's Disney Diary in the WDW Fan Zone. We'll see you next time.
Here's another view of the new Spice Row Table from across World Showcase Lagoon. You can see it located just to the left of the Moroccan Pavilion facing World Showcase Lagoon, where the Friendship Boat Launch is. Now, before we take a closer look inside, let's look at what used to be in this location. Here's a satellite view of the Morocco Pavilion before construction. Now, you can see the boat launch for the Friendship Boats, and right next to it, you can see the location where Spice Road Table now stands. This used to be a character meet and greet for Jasmine and Aladdin, a gift shop, and the stage for Moroccan that you might have seen them play on once or twice. Here's a picture of the old stage. In fact, the only thing that's still in the same place is the water wheel that you see here in the picture. Here's a picture before the construction, a picture during construction, and a picture after. You can see the only thing in the before and after picture being the water wheel. Now let's look at a map, both before and after construction. Now what's happened is this location's been completely replaced with the Spice Row. Here's some concept art that Disney released for the Spice Row. You can clearly see the dessert and juice bar, the Art of Henna, the marketplace, and the Spice Row Table Bar with outdoor and indoor seating.
If you don't have time to go inside, you can grab a dessert or a beverage right at the new counter service location outside on the corner of the new Spice Row building. The new location also includes a gift shop all before you get to the Spice Row Table restaurant.
The merchandise in the Gift of Morocco gift shop is very similar to the other merchandise that you'll find in Morocco. What I like most about the location, next to the Art of Henna tattoos and before the entrance to the bar, is that it doesn't take any viewing away from Illuminations. In fact, the indoor seating is on the other side of this wall. Let's go and take a look inside. As soon as you walk into Spice Road Table, you'll see the bar with the water wheel, beautiful decorations, and of course the bar. So before I even checked out the seating, I checked out the menu, which is Mediterranean small plates. So this is more than just Moroccan cuisine. In fact, you'll find dishes from Spain, Portugal, Greece, France, Turkey, Morocco, and Lebanon, which is almost like having a food and wine festival inside a building all the time. Now, we didn't know where to start, so I asked the bartender.
Hello, WDW Fan Zone, Sam's Disney Diary. I'm checking out the new Spice Row here in Morocco in Epcot. So, how long have you been here?
3 days.
3 days?
That's
awesome. So, looking at the menu, I love the mussels, the shrimp, the calamari. Where do I start?
Or the fried calamari. You can do all of them in one plate, which is the Mogador sampler. You get the mussels, you get the salted cod, and you get the fried calamari.
So what's Mogador?
Mogador is the name of the city in Morocco.
Okay, it's a city.
So yes, because Morocco is the colony of Portuguese.
Right.
So this Mogador is the Portuguese name. That's it.
It must be by the sea, because it's our sea.
Yes.
All right. What's the other city?
Sorry about all the background noise. Of course, I like to order everything on the menu, but basically it came down to two samplers. The Manglador, which is mussels, salted cod, and fried calamari. Now, Manglador being named after a city near a bay, so this is the seafood sampler. And the Tinga sampler, lamb sliders, chicken roll, sausage, named after a city on the prairie. So more of your land sampler. Let's wait for our Manglador and get a Moroccan beer in the meantime.
This is Chef Rashid, and this brings in the Manglador sampler.
Awesome. Thank you, Chef.
There you go. Enjoy it, sir.
All right, what do we have here?
That's the Manglador with the salted cod croquettes, the mussels, and the fried calamari.
Oh, that calamari looks great.
Enjoy.
Thank you. This is the salted cod. Almost a hush puppy. Very good. Not very spicy. Good on the tongue. Calamari, very good, nice and soft. And the mussels, not in the shell, which is a bonus. I expected to be taking them out of the shell. Very unique flavor.
Okay, I got a little carried away at the bar. Now, in addition to grabbing a bite at the bar, you can also get a table outside with some wonderful views of World Showcase Lagoon, or grab a table inside where the music is pumped in for Illuminations every night. It's small, but it's a great viewing opportunity. Now, no reservations here, so you need to get in line early and grab a table right at the World Showcase Lagoon for Illuminations. Now, as good as the Manglador sampler was, I just had to get back to try the Tingus. So later that day, I headed back to Spice Roll Table, took a seat inside to see how Illuminations
work. Welcome to Spice Roll Table. My name is Ali. I'll be your Mediterranean server tonight. We offer in a nice combination of different food from different Mediterranean countries. Pretty much we represent Morocco, Greece, Turkey, and also Spain as well, and Lebanon. So the different food made with some olive oil and some typical spices.
Okay.
We feed the spices in the food as well. The food comes from the kitchen at no particular order, so the cold one come out to your table fast, then the hot ones.
Okay.
And talking about drinks, pretty much we have some excellent organic sangria, red and white, and also we have some excellent aperitif. Thinking about aperitif, typical drinks that they have before the meal.
Okay.
The appetites. We have also on the fly right here. Drinks. Beside that, we have different beers right there. We got beer from different Mediterranean countries. Wine also, and have some excellent cocktails right here.
Wonderful.
Yeah. If you allow me to go around the food right here, so.
Sure.
Pretty much. I try most of it, and there is a lot of items that I have a good feedback about. Definitely the calamari is one of my favorite. It comes with some two different sauces, got spicy sauce, and also got the creamy pickle sauce.
Okay.
Beside that, we have the famous hummus. Hummus is basically, it comes with two types. We got the regular hummus, and also got the tomato hummus. And also it comes with some imported olives as well. Pita bread, very famous. And also we have the lamb slider, one of the good... the good items I'll have a good feedback about as well.
Great, I'll take a look.
Absolutely, take a look. I'll get you some water to start with. I'll be right back, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, enjoy.
So this was easy. I knew what I wanted before I sat down, the Tinga sampler, but man, that hummus sure sounds good.
Chicken spring roll right there. Typically make some cheese, beans, and also got some harissa, lemon juice, and olive oil. And they serve some harissa right in the bottom right there, so it's pretty spicy.
Okay.
And they got the lamb slider, typical lamb with some brioche. And also the sauce will be tzatziki sauce, which is made out of yogurt and cucumber. Served with some tomato and also olive salad in the bottom. The Moroccan mergas, sausage made with the lamb. Also got some lemon juice, olive oil, and a lot of spices in there. So it's typical like spicy sausage as well.
Great, and my beer's from where?
This is from Spain.
Okay.
Pretty cool. Famous beer and kind of a little dark, so enjoy.
We're all good for it. Thank you.
Enjoy.
If I'm going to enjoy the cuisine, you got to check out Illuminations from inside Spice Road Table. Let's see what the angle looks like from here.
The audio's wonderful, pumped in, clear as can be. But if you look at a map as to where Spice Road Table is and the center of the lagoon, you'll notice two small islands obstructing the view. Now, it's not that bad, Most of the fireworks in the air are absolutely perfect, but there's a few sequences that are on the ground, specifically the start of the show and the middle when the globe's going out, where it's a little difficult to see exactly what's happening. That said, it's still a wonderful, relaxing place to watch Illuminations. That light that you see in the right of the picture is actually a reflection to one of the lights inside Space Road Table. The angle is to the right, looking out of the window. I couldn't get my camera against the glass and still get Illuminations in view. That said, here's a quick look at Illuminations from Space Road Table. So it might not be the best view, but it's a darn good view. If it's your first time seeing Illuminations, you might want to try another location without any obstructions in your way. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this quick look at the new Spice Road Table in Morocco. Check out my blog, samsdisneydiary.com. I did a full review of Illuminations Reflections of Earth for Epcot's 30th birthday. Check out samsdisneydiary.com, search for Illuminations, and you'll find episode number 20. All of my videos, Sam's Disney Diary, and trips into the WDW Fan Zone at youtube.com/samsdisneydiary. And to get all of my stuff, follow me on Twitter at Sam's Disney Diary. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you next time.
We hope that your visit to the Walt Disney World Resort has been a truly magical experience for you and yours. We wish you a pleasant evening and a safe journey home. Thank you, and good night.
Sam's Disney Diary. You never know just what we'll see.